Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, and I truly mean that. And I'm also going to add welcome to some of my growing and going dear friends. And that's beginning to happen. So I thank you for that. You're not just a listener. You've taken the time to get connected, and our friendship is growing. And I like that because as I've taught radio to young adults, many of them just getting a start in radio around the world, I simply told them that your first job is to make as many friends as possible. That's right. Make as many friends as possible. And they, of course, were all thinking about getting their message out and playing their music and being kind of a radio rock star. I reminded them that this business works best when you have friends, and then maybe even a few fans, and maybe one or two fanatics who think you're just great. Or at least they like what you do, or they appreciate you. So thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you, and welcome, friends. Monday meets the marketplace, and truly, in the United States, this is the day. The years of politicking and certainly chaos, confusion, COVID connection comes to a real head as the election takes place tomorrow. And that's why I'm going to be very short today, because if you're listening from the United States, you are hearing all of the last minute words. Unfortunately, perhaps not a lot of wisdom, but certainly a lot of words where people are simply saying, choose me, choose me, choose me. And we'll get by. And so it'll be interesting to see what happens tomorrow. Well, I have a few interesting ideas about that, maybe. And the program begins right now. One of the questions I oftentimes ask people, in fact, as a business performance coach, the regular people now get ready to expect it. And here it goes. I say, since we last met, since we last talked, what is clearer to you now? What is clearer to you now? And that question has gotten me a certain amount of, you know, good feelings. People say, great. It has also cost me a little bit of money because one time, in fact, it happened a couple times, a client called me up and they canceled their coaching appointment. And I said, anything wrong? He said, oh, no, Stan, I'm just really busy right now. And I know the first question you are going to ask me is, what is clearer to me now? And you know, all of a sudden I sat down and it came to me, and now I know what to do, so I don't have to have you come in this week. That's right. That's good. And actually, it's not original with me. I use it a lot, but supposedly it's the legend of the great transcendental philosophers, you know, Thoreau, Emerson, in the Massachusetts colony, state of Massachusetts in the 18th century, when they would meet philosophically or friendly around Walden Pond, that's what they said. Since we last met, since we last talked, what is clearer to you now? And one of my heroes, at least in the radio business, was and still is to some extent, Dennis Prager, who says that's what he oftentimes seeks. Not necessarily agreement, but perhaps clarity. What is clearer to you now? Well, a couple things are clear to me, I think, and, well, three things. First of all, I am more and more convinced that the three words that I should be using more and more, and as I'm getting older, I'm using them more and more. Do you know what they are? I think you do. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. Who's going to win? I don't know. What's going to happen? I don't know. Who's telling the truth? I don't know. Now, I oftentimes also, just as the title says, just because I don't know, that doesn't mean I don't have an opinion, but I'm trying to make sure that if I do have an opinion, I know something about it. And more, I'm just simply saying is, I don't know. And then I simply turn it to the people and say, what do you know? What is clear to you now? Is there any way I could be helpful to you? I hope you're seeing some of the method in my madness. So that's a little bit clearer to me now. Second thing I know, I think I know, is clearer to me now, is we ought to get rid of this daylight savings time or summer savings time. More and more, okay, in the autumn you fall back, and in the spring you spring forward. They're now discovering that more and more the changing of the clocks, which obviously seems to be a very simple thing. It's only an hour and it's only about daylight. You know, what's the deal? That actually our bodies very much get into much more rhythm than we think. And particularly even for children. And so the every 6 month disruption in the rhythm by just an hour or so is probably bringing more trouble than it is worth. And so more and more, I'm agreeing with some of the articles that I saw over the weekend where it is just argued, hey, we've got enough confusion in our lives. Why should we have more confusion as to what time it is? We should perhaps agree on that and stay the same. The interesting thing was for 15 years until my recent move here into the Carolinas, I lived in Arizona. And Arizona prides itself, you know, down there in the desert area. They say they're mavericks. That means they want to be different than everybody else. But they do not go on summertime or daylight savings time. They just keep the same time all year. And that means that I think they're the one full state. Now, there are some other areas, one full state that just doesn't do that. And so, you know, for many years, it never affected me. I was never thinking about it. And, you know, things kind of worked out just fine. One of them says from Arizona, well, you know, we get plenty of sunshine here, so we don't need to save any. We don't need more daylight savings time. And that is true. One of the wonderful things that I truly enjoyed and still do, because I have friendships and business still in Arizona, is that what they say, Tucson, Arizona, has probably more sunny days than any place in America. We average well over 300 days where we have sunshine. It's one of the few places where sometimes we just even welcome a cloudy day. It was kind of different, and we didn't like that. So there we go. I don't know. And secondly, is we should probably get rid of daylight savings time. Those are two things I think I know. And maybe there's a third that is just a little more vital and a little more important. And we'll talk about that when I come back. Well, I am back just for a few minutes. Literally, because I changed states. I'm not being the best of citizens because I left Arizona, and remember, it's basically a state election, and I entered Carolina, again, a state election. There's no presidency involved. I just decided that I was no longer able to speak on behalf of the people who should run Arizona or represent Arizona because I wasn't living there anymore. And since I'm so brand new to Carolina and I don't know everything about it, I didn't know any of the people who were seeking major office. So I said, you know, I'm just not informed enough. I just don't know enough. I don't really have a true place right now, so I'm just not going to vote. I'm just not going to vote. And that's true. And my wife and I decided that what we would simply do is that we would pray that, you know, that the spirit force might really be, that God might really be involved in empowering what is right and what is good. Empowering what is right and what is good. And we didn't put any names to that. We didn't put any names to that prayer. We just simply said, you know, as we say, as I said yesterday when I went to church, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And, you know, that's basically how I'm going to try and look at the voting situation, at least more and more. And so, as my wife said, Stan, you used to be a real fanatic about sports. And I said, yeah, I sure was. She said, you don't really pay that much attention to it anymore. I said, no, I guess I don't. And she said, what happened? And I said, well, I guess I just didn't care that much. You know, I'm glad when the Cubs win, but, you know, it doesn't mean that much anymore to me. And, you know, I'm happy when the Vikings win, but unfortunately, cheering for the Vikings was no fun because they're one of the few teams that's never won a Super Bowl. So, you know, I just didn't do it anymore. So I'm not cheering for any particular side in a number of things where I used to. However, what I am seeking to say is I think we have to be so very, very careful right now. What has happened is that a significant decision was made by the people who voted, and they elected the Democrats, Joseph Biden, to run the presidency, and the Democrats to run the House of Representatives, and now also the Senate. And now what we discover, that it seems that 2 years later, it appears that there's been a major change of heart and mind. And so what I'm just simply saying is, I think all of us, no matter what side we are on, no matter what side we are voting for, I think we need, when all is said and done, and it might be a while, what does this really mean? Big change from Donald Trump 2 years ago, maybe a big change about Joseph Biden now. What does this mean? And how should it affect me, my business, and how I can be better at who I am and better at what I do. Better at who I am and better at what I do, and how can I now serve my audience better? So can I just remind you that I think that's something, no matter what happens, I oftentimes try to tell people that the reason we do this little program is to just help you be better at who you are. We're not necessarily here to change you. Changing is for somebody else who has more wisdom and a power and authority than I do. Just better at who you are and better at what you do. And I would say better at who you serve. Because the principle of the universe, and this is what our politicians forget, their job is to serve others. That's the goal. How can you serve others? And most people who oftentimes find their way into the political arena, they always say it differently, but it turns out that for the most part, they serve their own agenda, their own ideas, and they just simply serve what they think is right and what benefits the people that they care for or like more than anybody else. So I'm done. I'll watch the election returns tomorrow. I probably won't have anything really to say about it tomorrow. I will just spend the time, and as a result, there won't be any program tomorrow. And then maybe on Wednesday, I might, if I know anything or think of anything, or if I hear from you, I might have something to talk about. As I say, I've got radio ramblings and sometimes a radio rant. And again, just because I don't know doesn't mean I don't have an opinion. I'm Stan Houston. I wish you all the best and blessings and more power to you, truly, in this time of great challenge and difficulty. Lots of people are in deep difficulty, and I will just simply pray the prayer and the blessing of more power to you. And bye for now.